Hello there, Fred. Good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and Harry is joining us today from Argentex because the company's revenue jumped by almost a quarter in the financial year just ended, and client trading volumes recovered throughout the period as market confidence rebounded from 2021, with volatility remaining high. We're going to discuss that and much, much more. And of course, a general market environment. Harry Adams is here with us now. Good to see you, Harry.
Hi, Casey. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure. So let's get stuck in here. Maybe just firstly, talk us about Argentex's performance over the last year. Let's start there.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, we were very pleased with the performance. It was a robust year. We're up 23% in terms of revenue. We're up just shy of 30% on operating profit. So all in all, it was a great year, given the operational changes that we went through.
Yeah. Are you able to speak through your newly defined corporate strategy as well?
Yeah, sure. So shortly after taking on the responsibility of sole CEO last summer, I conducted a full corporate and strategic review of the business. It was very clear that to fully capitalise on the huge growth opportunity, it was imperative that we evolved our strategy. So we did this, as I say, whilst delivering a solid set of results. It was also the first full year of my CFO. So the new strategy pivots around investment in people, investment in technology, and investment in overseas expansion.
And Harry, how are macroeconomic dynamics impacting your business today?
Yeah, I mean, just to remind you, our clients are predominantly corporate clients. They're sophisticated clients, and they're trading for commercial purposes. They're not trading for speculation. So, we are very robust in terms of our business model. We've proved on numerous occasions, especially given over the last 3 years and the Black Swan events, that we'll thrive in whatever macroeconomic background there is. So taking the most updated one and the inflation crisis actually plays into our hands a little bit, because the likelihood is that the clients will trade maybe a little bit more notional currency. Also, the way that central banks are tackling inflation, that is by increasing interest rates across the world, that gives us sort of a new cost to carry between those currencies that yields a little bit more take for us on forward contracts and options contracts.
What is the outlook for the market as you look ahead?
I don't have a crystal ball. All I can tell you is that from what I hear from our clients, you know, there is more certainty than was around this time last year and back in Brexit. Clearly, with the news overnight, there is unease, I guess, from the UK. But this is one of the reasons why we're looking to invest in overseas territories. And that's really sort of diversify our revenue opportunity.
Mm-hmm. And how is the mood of customers given the current economic situation, would you say?
Yeah, I mean, the mood of our clients doesn't really change an awful lot. The litmus test for us is actually how far forward do they tend to book their hedges. Now, what we've seen historically in terms of Brexit and then COVID is that length of tenor, that length of commitment, I guess, shortens. People are sitting on their hands a little bit, potentially waiting to see what happens. We've seen no evidence of that. And I think that sort of comes through in our Q1 revenue, which was incredibly promising.
What realistic market share is Argentex targeting?
Yeah, that's really difficult to answer. However, we do estimate that in the EMEA, from a report on McKinsey back in 2020, that market share could be up to $52 billion. Across Australia, we think it'd be around about $2.5 billion Aussie dollars. But really, you know, one thing to remember is that 85% of clients are still trading their foreign exchange with the bank. So, you know, really that's sort of the market that we're targeting. We know that the overall payments and FX market is absolutely vast. And really, we are a rounding error in the UK market alone.
Right. Let's talk about tech. What's next for the company's tech innovations?
Well, we launched our new technology offering earlier on this year and been really pleased with the uptake of our current client base. That's up 700% in terms of revenue. Fair enough, it's from a low base. We're investing more currently, and we expect to launch a new product in the next 3 months. And the likelihood is that we'll follow up, be followed on by the new virtual IBAN product and the mass payments product towards the end of this year.
And you've alluded to this. What are your plans to expand anywhere else after Australia?
I think we're doing a lot right now. And, you know, we want to be mindful that, of course, irrespective of the size of the market in the UK and Europe and Australia, you know, there's an awful lot to go after. So slowly but surely, I think we'll look to increase our footprint across Europe into EU. And then we'll see where we go from there.
All right, Harry Adams, thank you very much indeed from Argentex here on Proactive London.
Thank you, Katie. We'll be right back.